Talking, everyone. We are in the kitchen with Miss Allison Davis right here at Wild Thyme Cooking. How are you doing?
I'm great.
Awesome.
Great.
And we've been working on appetizers.
Yep.
And so you have something today for us,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, and this one is definitely keto friendly.
Okay.
We've talked about that in the past. And so I wanted to just highlight a simple recipe. It's a bacon wrapped pickle fry with like a ranch dipping sauce, or you could really just do just about anything.
Awesome.
Just some mustard on the side, really.
Yeah.
But it's super simple. I've got some ready. I'm gonna go ahead and show this, and then we're gonna talk a little bit about the keto diet because you had been asking me about that,
I know.
I thought this would be a perfect chance to kind of talk about it.
Yep.
So real quick, I take like a thick cut bacon,
okay,
and then I go with the pickle spears,
okay,
and then we just start from one end and then just literally just wrap it from one end to the other.
Okay. And now, do you use dill, sweet? What kind of pickles
dill
do you
pickles
prefer?
For dill? Sure.
Okay.
Yeah, I want the salty combination with the bacon
gotcha.
Here happening. So literally, we're just wrapping and covering it and putting it in the oven and letting it kind of crisp up.
All right.
But I wanted to talk about keto because I have been researching it. We've got a class coming up in the first week of November for a ketogenic class.
Mm-hmm.
And I find it just really interesting, and it's one of the most researched kind of diets and food words that's out there.
Right.
It's similar to the Atkins diet,
mm-hmm.
But what it really focuses in on is your good healthy fats, like your, well, maybe not so much your bacon, but like your avocados and your almonds, your nuts, your, you know, olives, those kind of things that are the healthy fats.
Mm-hmm.
And so when you are on a ketogenic diet, you basically are eliminating sugar and glucose from your diet.
Okay.
No processed carbs, no breads.
Okay.
Eliminating the carbs, basically, where you have a very low carb intake.
Mm-hmm.
Your body, over a period of time, will transition from using sugar and glucose for fuel, which is what we typically see is we use for energy, is where we'll eat our carbs, and that gives us energy to kind of keep going, and so we use the carbs for energy, which turn into glucose. But the glucose we don't use as fuel is what ends up turning into
fat
in our bodies.
It stays on our bodies,
exactly.
Right?
So if we eliminate that glucose, then we start to use the fat for fuel,
mm-hmm.
and then our bodies turn into more of what's called a fat-burning mode.
Yeah, kind of like a furnace, right?
And
I mean,
so
it's kind of turning on the furnace on your body.
And if we're eating those good fats and our body's burning fats, that's what's giving us energy and then makes us feel really good.
Mm-hmm.
And then we're also seeing people with a good bit of weight loss.
Mm-hmm.
So I just find that really interesting. We're going to do a class with some other recipes similar to this, but like breakfast, lunch, dinner, ways that we can incorporate these recipes into our daily life and try to live a more ketogenic lifestyle with those low carbs.
Well, and I loved it too when you told me about this diet because, number one, you can still eat meats and lots of them.
And dairy.
And dairy.
Which I think
and
is
the dairy
interesting
part,
for a lot of people.
See, and that was the interesting part for me because I love dairy. I really do love milk. And
and I have so many people that come in and they talk about their digestive issues and really like the first two things, and I see this from medical professionals as well, like the first two things they will usually tell you to eliminate is your gluten and soy. So eliminating those first two to see how you feel.
Right.
And that in itself is going to help lower your carb intake.
Uh-huh.
And then if you kind of offset that with some nice local or, you know, good fats, like clean fats, you should start to really see a difference and you may even lose weight in the process.
See the difference and feel the difference,
too. Right, exactly.
I mean, I know putting my son on a gluten-free diet, we definitely, within 2 weeks, we saw a difference in his, and he has autism, but it helped to reduce some of that stemming that he was doing with
autism. I've seen a lot of reports on that and how that has really helped with just autistic children and even ADHD. Eliminating gluten and how that helps their mood.
And it's not a cure by all means, but we could see a difference.
Yeah.
And you know, so I can see how food has a direct correlation with that, with your body, with your energy, with your blood going to your brain.
Yeah, because the ketogenic actually started back in the 1900s when they were working on epileptic seizures and how it helped to eliminate that. So there's a big thing there with the food and the brain and all of that
awesome.
Working together. Yeah.
Well, very interesting. I love it. Well, for this recipe, because we've got pickles wrapped in bacon.
And we have some done here, yes, so we can go ahead and try.
Awesome. But for this recipe and many other recipes, head over to our website at WTVQ.com/MiddayKentucky, or you can head over to Allison's website at wildtimecooking.com, and you're also on Instagram.
You try
right?
that, and my Instagram is at Chef Allison Davis. And we'll be right back. Thank you all, and thank you for being here at Wild Time.
Sure, thank you.